Get ready to match the stars from Mork and Mindy, Robert Donner, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly from The Young and the Restless, Melody Thomas, McLean Stevenson, and Marcia Wallace as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rimmer.
Thank you, John. Thank you, friends.
I agree with you. Welcome. Thank you for showing up. Thank you for showing up here. Some little gnome keeps putting these thoughts for the day right there.
What is it? It
says, living on Earth may be expensive, but it includes an annual free trip around the sun.
Take that down.
You don't think that's very good, eh? All right, let's get it.
They're much better than that.
Yes.
Could I have a copy of that?
Sure.
Oh, thank you so much.
I want you to keep that. Mm-hmm. Listen, we got a new kid on the block, and we must give her a proper welcome. She is from The Young and Restless, and we're delighted to have Melody Thomas with us. And just want to say welcome.
Thank you.
Where'd you learn to kiss like that?
My dress, that's all.
Your dress?
Yeah.
Oh, yes. How much do you weigh, Melody?
Oh, Gene, please. Show. Do you want to see the dress?
Yeah, let him show him the dress. I've got to see that.
I work across the hall every day on Young and Restless, and I know a lot of the people back here. And one stage hand said, Mel, your dress is on backwards, because I was in such a rush trying to get ready, and they said that I should be wearing it the other way.
Uh-huh.
So I'm sorry. I apologize. All right. I'll do better.
Well, you're doing the best you can, but
yes.
No one's perfect.
That's right.
Except you. Let's say hello to Rochelle Anapolsky and Gabrielle Williams. Welcome, ladies. Let's get acquainted. Rochelle, tell us about you, please.
Hi. I'm married and have a little girl, and I'm hoping to get into commercials.
Really?
Yeah, and I'm having a ball here.
Good. Well, wait till the show starts.
Yeah.
Gabrielle, tell us about you.
Hello, I'm Gabrielle, and I'm married. I have a little son, DJ. Hello. And I'm a program technician and in real estate, and I'm just having fun here today.
Good. Nice to have you both with us. Good luck to both of you. Rochelle, you go first.
A, please.
All right. This is it. Sid said there's something wrong with my television set. I can see two commercials at the same time. It's disgusting. Some guy is brushing his teeth with blank. All right,
you
Rochelle,
and Charles,
I guess we're ready for
really
you.
A Robert.
Sid said there's something wrong with my television. Said I can see two commercials at the same time. It's disgusting. Some guy is brushing his teeth with blank.
Preparation H.
All right. That's a good one. Now, she thought about that a long time, came up with a pretty good answer. What do
yes,
you
she did. I was in the right area.
Yeah.
I said baby powder.
Baby powder.
Very good.
All right, that's a good one. Two good ones so far. Brett?
Oh, I didn't even come close. I said Tide.
Tide?
Comet.
Comet? Yes. Well, it's... See, Comet would be kind of painful. Good. Not disgusting was the operative word here.
I'm sorry. That's a wonderful answer, but I have a personal connection with that immediately. Recently, my housekeeper put Lysol in my toothbrush.
Now, that would be
and I
disgusting.
Went home and started to brush my teeth. And
that must have hurt a lot.
Yeah.
Two commercials at the same time. It's disgusting. Some guy is brushing his teeth with what, McLean?
For lack of a better thought, I put Alpo.
Alpo. That's genuinely disgusting.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
So disgusting is the operative word, which is so often the case on the Match Game.
Right.
Rochelle has my old hair. Did you notice that?
Oh,
remember
yes,
when
does.
I had that hair?
Right, I do remember that.
More human interest. Tidy Bowl.
Tidy Bowl. All right. Now, Gabrielle, let's see what we have for you. Vin said, you know the price of food is too high when you discover your wife has traded the blank for a hamburger. Sound of mellifluous laughter is music to my ears. Finn said, you know the price of food is too high when you discover your wife has traded the blank for a hamburger.
Your child.
Your child?
Yes.
Oh, I've known days when I would trade my kids for a lot less than a hamburger.
But, well, wait. What'd you say there?
Well, I would imagine that it all depends upon how secure your marriage is. I said the wedding ring.
The wedding ring.
Yes.
All right. The wedding ring for a hamburger. Okay, Brett.
I don't know, but you know I was talking to Betty White last night.
Yeah.
And she said she didn't mean to go off animals, but she traded the dog.
She's only funning, Betty. She didn't say that.
I'm only kidding, Betty.
In keeping with the two B's and the boring C, car.
Car? Yeah, that would indicate the price of food is high, right?
Yes.
Right. You know the price of food is too high, and Discovery Wife has traded the child.
When you are really hungry, Gene.
When you're really hungry.
Not just your child, but your firstborn.
Your firstborn. Wow.
That's one for you.
New Kid on the Block has to come up with the first match, all you veterans.
That's right.
All right, McLean.
You know, Gene, I very rarely come up with the right answer, but I do come up with some little informative tidbits that I might like to pass on at this point.
Yes, we'd like to have one right now.
With the new cars that are going out, as you know, and the new cars coming in, they're offering as much as $500 on a purchase of a new car, even
right.
This late in the year.
You need background music for this?
Not at all.
No. All right.
A lot of people can't afford to do it as big as I did. I went out and purchased 10 cars and made $5,000 in a little less than 3 minutes.
No kidding.
Oh, on rebates.
What a stroke of genius.
Isn't that something?
Yes, indeed.
Gee, okay. That was interesting, wasn't it?
Thank you. Well, so much for the B's and so much for the M's. Car.
Car, right.
All right, now just another of the many things that Melody and I are going to have in common. Don't start. Baby.
Baby. That's two. All right. So there we are, the end of round one, 2-0. Gabrielle's favorite. Now this for you. Here we go. Round two coming up. And Gabrielle, since you're ahead, the rule states that you must go first.
Okay, and I'll select A.
A it is. Ready?
Melody and I don't write. Melody and I.
We
no,
can't
you don't write.
Write.
No, because you matched in the previous round. No, you can write.
Now shape up, Mr. Rayburn.
All right, I'm shaping up. Look at me. I'm standing up straight and everything. Unlucky Louis said, I have the world's worst luck. For years, I waited for my ship to come in. Unfortunately, my ship was the blank. Here we go. Well, I'm going to start, John. Unlucky Louis said, I have the world's worst luck. For years, I waited for my ship to come in. You know that figurative phrase, don't you? Unfortunately, my ship was the blank.
Last.
The last?
Last ship.
I guess you didn't get the drift here of what they were trying to do to you. Give her the drift, Bob.
Here's one drift, Andrea Doria.
Andrea Doria. You understand now?
Yes.
Well, what do you say we start all over again? waiting for my ship to come in. Unfortunately, my ship was the...
D'Angelo, whatever he said.
Whatever he said. All right, Bob, that's one. Andrea Doria, what have you got there?
Oh, it's Andrea Doria? Oh, I thought it was last.
I'm just trying to work with you, Gabrielle.
All right. What do you got for us?
Marcia said something wonderful one day. She said, changing agents is like changing deck chairs on the Titanic. The
Titanic. All right. That's the other good answer.
The Titanic.
All right. So, her answer is the last. For years, I waited for my ship to come in. Unfortunately, my ship was the what, McLean?
The Titanic.
All right. Had a bunch of those and one Andrea Doria. Now, Rochelle, you need 2 to tie and 3 to win. Dumb Dora is really dumb.
Yeah. How dumb is she?
She thinks higher education means the students are on blanks. You want to read it? You don't want to read it.
Oh, I'm sharp as a tack.
Good. Here we go. Rochelle, Dumb Dora is really dumb. She thinks higher education means the students are on blanks.
Drugs.
Drugs. Okay, she says drugs, Bob.
Boy, I tell you, I feel like Wrong Way Corrigan. I said stilts.
Stilts is a good one. Drugs are good, stilts good. There are 3 or 4 really good ones to this.
Drugs,
what do you say?
I feel just a little bit behind the times, and I shouldn't because I have a child who just graduated from high school. I said ladders.
Ladders? All right, Charles.
36-year-old child that graduates from high school has no sense bragging about a situation like that.
For my fabulous
ladders.
All right. Dumb Dora thinks higher education means the students are on...
Huh? Well, rude, man.
All right. Good acting, you see, for someone who's never tried them.
That's
wasn't that
right.
Sincere and well done? All right, McLean.
Now, I'm totally a toast to this.
Totally a toast to this?
Something has happened to my mouth. I had my body capped recently,
sure,
Gene.
Sure, you did.
Yeah, and they didn't get them out right. I said drugs, although I am very much opposed to their use.
Right. Nice score.
This sweet woman, a mother of one,
yeah,
is over there cheering on drugs. Isn't that terrible what this show does to people?
Right.
Oh, it's up to me, right?
Right.
But no pressure, right?
No pressure.
Wrong. Ladders.
Ladder. All right. So we end up with a tie for this game. That means we go to the tiebreaker. One question for each. The one who's matched the most will be the winner. And, Rochelle, you can go first.
A.
He's the nurse.
All right.
Today.
You are. This is a tiebreaker. Art said, my prom date was really weird.
How weird was she?
She had blank on the spaghetti straps of her gown. You know what spaghetti straps are? Those thin things that hold up a dress. All right, Michelle. Art said my prom date was really weird. She had blank on the spaghetti straps of her gown.
Meatballs.
Meatballs. What do you got?
Do you know that I usually sit tall when I have the right answer?
Right.
Boy, I have an awful low all day
slumping,
long.
Slumping, huh?
Thank God I can draw a meatball.
Aha!
Okay, one for Rochelle.
I have a confession to make. I looked over and I thought, meatball? P-U. And wrong again, tomato and meat sauce.
Tomato and meat sauce.
I just said sauce, Uncle Gene.
No marinara?
No.
None of that, huh? I was expecting someone who likes Italian food as you do.
Well, I was going to say clam sauce, but then that's hard to match, so I just...
All right.
I don't know what I did.
Ms. Melody, my prom date was really weird. She had blank on the spaghetti straps of her gown. What do you say to that?
Well, I originally had tomato sauce, and after much hesitation, I did change it, but it doesn't match anyway. I'm sorry, Parmesan cheese.
Parmesan, no. It's all right, from a bella ragazza. What do you say?
What was the answer that she gave again? I'm sorry.
Meatballs.
Ah. Meatballs, dear.
You got it.
Aha!
Here's your Rochelle. Oh.
All right, Marcia, show us your meatballs.
But there's no need to be rude. It's true. Not real big, but...
Meat sauce. All right, Rochelle ends up with two. That means when we get to you, you'll have two to tie and three to win. Now this for you.
Joe, Mr. Gene River.
Thank you, John. Now, Gabrielle, two to tie, three to win. Ready? We're in the tiebreaker.
Oh, boy.
Did you hear about the mad scientist?
People, pay attention, please.
Did you hear about the mad scientist who crossed a parrot with an owl? You can replace Brett. He's got an owl that says, who blank? Can I go over that one more?
Boy, that's confusing.
All right, Gabby. Did you hear about the mad scientist who crossed a parrot with an owl? He's got an owl that says, who blank?
Who? Polly.
Who Polly? Two isn't much to win a game, but I think you're safe. All right, Gabrielle, I think you missed us there. What do you say, Bob?
Gabrielle, I'm trying, believe me. Who wants a cracker?
Yeah.
Polly wants a cracker.
Yeah.
Who Wants a Cracker?
And friend of Who Wants a Cracker?
Who Wants a Cracker?
Who Wants a Cracker?
Oh, you plugging the Jupiter Police Department,
yes.
Are you?
They I did something for everybody.
You could arrest everybody? All right, you can start with me. A mad scientist crossed a parrot with an owl. He's got an owl that says, who?
I had absolutely no idea, so I just thought, who cares?
Who cares?
If the sun,
I like your spirit.
Cares to fall.
All right, now you got to match McLean and Marcia to stay in the game. What do you say there?
I said, owl said, who did this to me?
Who did this to me? So that means, who cares? And Rochelle wins the game. Come on down, Rochelle. On the little blue dot there. We'll see you in a moment. And we're going to wheel this thing around, but you'll be back later for game number two, okay?
All right.
All right. Congratulations, my dear. Here we go with this big money super match where you could win over $10,000. Here it is. We polled a studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Edie blank. Edie blank.
Brett.
Oh, one of my favorite singers in the whole wide world, Edie Gourmet.
All right. Marcia.
Marcia. Another one of my favorite singers, Idi Amin.
Edie Amin? That's your answer?
That's
all right.
And Charles.
Edie Adams.
Edie Adams, Edie Gourmet, Edie Amin are the three
Don't
they've given
Edie
you.
Edie Fisher.
Who do you want? One of those or one of your own?
No, Edie Gourmet.
All right.
What have I got? I don't have now.
Let's find out if Edie Gourmet is up there. Let's go down to the bottom, reveal a $100 response. Edie Albert.
Oh, you get a great group.
And her brother, Eddie.
Right. Well, no, that audience, you see, no one spoke it aloud to them. They had to read it, and a lot of them says, oh, E.D.I. das Eddie Albert. All right. Here we go with the next one, the $250 response. Edie Adams. There's Charles' answer. Edie Gourmet is probably on top, I would venture a guess. Here we go. Yeah.
Oh, don't make it hurt. So excited. I've never had this much money in my life.
Turn your head away. Okay, that'll calm her down now. All right. Now, you've won $500. That means the least you'll play for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. But I hesitate to ask you to do this. You're going to spin the wheel. And if you're lucky, it'll stop on one of the stars' names. And then you'll be playing for $10,000. If it stops at the star, I'm afraid you're going to spoil yourself. Get up there.
Grab any peg.
It must make one revolution, remember. And if you... You're playing for $5,000 with Bob Donner. Good luck to you. And face me, and here we go. Blank telephone. There it is, blank telephone. Bob's ready. Your job is to match him. If you do that, you get $5,000. What do you say to that, Rochelle? Blank telephone.
How about a pay telephone?
Pay telephone. How about a pay telephone? All right, Bob, you got a pay telephone?
I'm afraid to say pay telephone.
Well,
even if I had it, I mean, if she did that for $500, what is she going to do to me?
I don't know. Let's find out.
I don't know. Pay telephone.
Gene Reverend, join us next time for the Match Game. Thank you. Goodbye.
Bye. Today's contestants will also receive Fabergé Collection featuring organic shampoo and conditioner with pure wheat germ oil and honey for fresh-smelling hair with Super Shine Super Body. And Flavor Ice, America's favorite quick-freeze fruit-flavored bars. 24 giant bars in the package. Assorted delicious flavors. Flavor Ice, the giant cooler. Easy Caulker, foam caulker, and easy insulator for wider gaps. No gun, no mess with either can. Easy Caulker, easy insulator. Raid Crack and Crevice Spray. Unique extension wand sprays hard-to-reach places to kill crawling bugs. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for Broadway.
Okay, Todd, you can come out. She's gone.